Sir, my dear students and fellows, welcome to all and to good evening to today's lecture. And sorry for that, for interruption and also delayed lecture as I am not in the Dhaka now. So thank you very much to participants around 42 in this evening. Let us start about the basics of pacemakers. Ended my lecture in the some basics of pacemakers, that is the pacing and sensing and also capture threshold, etc., etc. These are all the basic things. And as I do concluded that day, as such, I am starting today the remaining part of the basics of pacemakers. That is the very important one, that is the pacemaker codes and modes. I think the basics of pacemaker lecture should be divided into two or three parts at least. Otherwise, it can never be concluded in one lecture. So, let us start with the what are the codes and modes in pacemaker. While we put in the pacemaker in a patient, we have to think the what should be the code and what should be the mode of that pacemaker, how it will be programmed. It should be known to all of us. So in the regarding the codes and modes, the history, I have told you that the in last lecture the history of pacemaker, it's a long way to go. And in regarding codes and modes, before 1974, the different companies and different hospitals made their own codes and modes, and there are not that much programming modes. And only the pacing in a fixed rate, the pacemaker pace and the different type of problem patient face. And doctors also encounter that type of problem. As such, in this regard, in 1974, there's the NICVD, that is the North American Society of Pacing and Electrophysiology. Now it is known as the Heart Rhythm Society of World. That is in 1974. They decided that the pacemaker should be in a program in a such a mode that it can be programmable, and it, the benefit of the program can be done by the physician. It can be possible. The program can be possible by the physician. So in 1974, they started some codes and modes, and in the later part, that is in 1987, British Pacing and Electrophysiology Group, that is the BPAG, they started the their codes and modes, and both of these, both the societies, so together we form the NBG code. We all of you know that the NBG code will be nowadays will be well known, all of you, and the NBG code, it is known as the NSP BPAG generic code. It is known as NBG code. So next one, the code is the some position in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like this, and in this position the NBG code is assigned by a letter, some letter. That is, that letter will be the combination of those letters that describes how the pacemaker will function. Let us see one by one. That is the some position will be the position 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It will be 5 positions. And in each position, the letters will be there, so that it can be it can mention the which mode the pacemaker is programmed. So in position 1 means that the chamber face, which chamber is face, it is mentioned by some letter. That is, if it is A, that is the atrium space. If it is B, the ventricle space. And if it is D, that is the dual A and B, that the atrium and ventricle both are pace. And if it is O, that is off or not. Similar way, that is the position 2 is mentioned with the chamber sense. That is the atrium, A for atrium, atrium is sense, or D for ventricle is sense, or D is dual, O is off. And the position 3 is resembled, that is the, what is the response to the sense? If pacemaker sends one impulse, then how it will respond? It is the chamber 3 will indicate, position 3 will indicate that that sense. Then the response to sense. If it is sense impulse, then it is limit, that is the eye, and another option is the T, that is the trigger, and the another option is D or dual, I or T, or O means off or none. I, that is inhibit, means the pacemaker will inhibit the, if it is sensory intrinsic rhythm, the pacemaker will inhibit. That is, it will not change, it will just sense the that event. And the T means it is a different type of meaning. T triggering means the usually no pacemaker is in the T mode, in the third position. No pacemaker is programmed in T mode because it is a different type of mode. That is, the T means the triggering. Actually, it means that the tracking, that is the tracking of the AV delay. Tracking of the AV delay is a very important part of the pacemaker programming. So, I will tell you later on about the T, that is the triggering mode. And if it is D in the third position, it is the dual, that is the inhibitor trigger, both the action can be done. And if it is O, that is off or none, very simple. And in the fourth position, that is the rate response, that is the rate response on or rate response off. Rate response means the, I'll say in the later slides, that is the in chronotropic incompetence patients, we will choose the rate response mode. And in the position 5, that is the multi-site pacing, that is the, it is not actually programmable, it is not actually in the program in the present era of pacemaker. Rotationally it needed, so it is very rare, that is the atrial pacing or atrial ventricle both pacing or ventricle a different site of pacing, atrium in atrium different site pacing. This type of mode it is. So it is not that much important in this present scenario. So I will tell you in later slide. Okay. So what are the course and modes according what I have told earlier? Can be single chamber mode and some dual chamber. That is the single chamber mode with the VOO and the VVI, the AOO and AAI. And in dual chamber modes are the GDD, VDD, and VDI, and DOO. These 448 dual mode of programmable issues are there. So we can describe it in the later slides one by one, so that you can understand all the modes. Many of you are already understood because it is some senior fellows are here and some are very new. So I am telling all the modes regarding because all of you understand. Is it true? Some of you are new here. Some of you are new here. All are old. Then I will skip.
Sir, I'm a notun rawachi, sir.
Some new fellows are here, okay?
Yes, sir.
Sir, kotha clear hocche na, sir. Ita ektu somoshya hocche, sir.
Acha, emnite kotha bojha jacche na, bojha na gele khub
clear bojha jacche na, sir.
Khub somoshya hocche, aste ekte beshi khola jabe na. Acha, N95 khulle to mushkil.
হ্যাঁ স্যার, আপনি তো বোধহয় বাইরে স্যার।
হ্যাঁ বাইরে। তুমি বলছো এমনি কি কিছু বোঝা যায় না? আমি এতক্ষণ যে বললাম
স্যার, বোঝা যায় কিন্তু একদম ক্লিয়ার হয় না আর কি স্যার।
একটু ধরে বলা মুশকিল,
মানে টার্ম স্যার যেটা অপরিচিত সেটা আর কি বোঝা যাচ্ছে না আর কি, পরিচিতটা বোঝা যায়।
এখন কি ক্লিয়ার বোঝা যায়? একটু বেটার আগে ঠিক আছে?
হ্যাঁ স্যার, এখন একটু বেটার স্যার।
বেটার, ওকে। এই রুবন, এখানে তো অনেক নতুন স্টুডেন্ট আছে তাই না? স্কিপ না করে সবগুলি বলাই বেটার হবে নাকি? তোমরা তো পুরানো যারা তারা তো সবাই বুঝবা মনে
হয় স্যার। নতুন পুরান সবাই আছে স্যার এখানে।
ওকে ঠিক আছে, তাহলে আমরা লেট আস ডিসকাস ওয়ান বাই ওয়ান দি অল দা মোডস। ওকে, what is VOO? That is the BOO means, that is the B, first letter is the B, that is the pacing in the ventricle. Second letter is O, that is the sensing is off. So no sensing, only pacing in the ventricle. Second position, what I have told earlier, that is the second position, the sense in the weak chamber. Chamber sensed, but there is no sensing. Sensing is off. And third letter was, that is the response to sensing. In O means off, that is the response to sensing is off. There is no response to sensing and there is no sensing. Only pacing in the ventricle. So pacemaker will only pace. It will not sense. But essentially what you end up with is the pacemaker that paces at a programmed rate. Only programmed rate it will pace, regardless of the heart's intrinsic activity. Whatever the heart's activity, it will not bother, it will just pace. How it is in this example, that is the pacemaker is set to a pace that is the 60 beats per minute or 1000 milliseconds. All of you know that the pacemaker is programmed in the millisecond term, and we are practicing it is the 60 beats per minute. So see the ratio is like that, so 60 bits per minute equivalent to 100,000 milliseconds. So in 1000 milliseconds in this example, that is the pacemaker is pacing every 1000 milliseconds. Whatever the impulse, it is the pacing impulse, that is the white QRS complex, so it is the pace event. After that, there is a P followed by normal intrinsic QRS complex, but pacemaker did not respond. Do not bother, patient just give an impulse. So it is a pace, paced event over the T wave. And again, there is no intrinsic wave, so it is paced, so the paced event. And again, it is the paced event, and it is the intrinsic event, but it would not have to pace, but it is paced in the T wave, according to the every 1000 milliseconds. So patient does not see anything. We just do it according to the program. If we program it in 1000 milliseconds, it will just pace according to that rate. So it is the VOO no more. Next one is the VBI. Close the door, please. So VBI, that is the first letter is the V, that is the pacing in the ventricle. And second letter is the V, the sensing in the ventricle. And third letter is inhibit. That is the third letter is inhibit. That is the if the pacemaker see any intrinsic event, it will not pace. It will just see, it will observe and inhibit the pacing. So with the VPI mode, pacemaker is capable of sensing the intrinsic activity by inhibiting the pacing when it is unnecessary. Okay, so it is the VPI mode. Let us see the example. In this example, the pacemaker is set to a lower rate limit, that is 60 beats per minute or 1000 milliseconds. So there is a sensed event, one the intrinsic activity of the heart, and the pacemaker is observing, it is the looking like a clock, it is the immediately sense the event and the pacemaker clock will start and it will just see every 1000 milliseconds what it is happening. So in after 1000 milliseconds, it is observing any impulse occur or not. If it occur, then it will just see inhibit pacing. So it is the intrinsic activity. It is also intrinsic activity. From here, it is just observed and not pace. So it is just sensed. Here, the clock is again starting from the sensed event. It is just in after 1000 milliseconds, it is not observing any intrinsic activity, so it is paced. So if a pacemaker observes any intrinsic activity, it will not pace. And if it is not observing all activity of own heart, so it will pace. So it is the VBI mode. Again, we can see that in this example is the pacing every 1000 interval. Suddenly one PVC comes, pacemaker will also observe that PVC. And if just clock started, that clock started from the PVC, and it will just measure again another 1000 milliseconds, and it will start pacing. So this is the VVR mode. Next one is the AOO mode. It is not practiced, but it is not useful nowadays for the patient, because only the pacing in the atrium only. There is no sensing is off, and response to sensing is also off. Only pacemaker, it is the asynchronous pacing, that is the just pacemaker will pacing in a fixed rate what we will set. So only pacing is there. Pacing is that every 70 beats per minute, pacemaker is pacing in the atrium, whatever the intrinsic activity. This pacing is accurate, that is the pacing followed by a POE, and is the own pure responses. It is also another appropriate pacing, but here there is...
Shoti.
Here there is own intrinsic POE, but it is pacing in the similar interval, in the QRS complex. So it is absolutely unnecessary. So it is the asynchronous pacing. It is pacing just in the rate of 70 beats per minute continuously. It does not bother whether the intrinsic beat are there or not. So it is the AOO mode. Next one is the AAI mode. That is the pacing in the atrium, sensing also in the atrium, and it is inhibitory to sense to the pace, sense to the intrinsic activity. So it is also similar to the VDI mode. The pacemaker will pace and see the intrinsic activity, and then it will inhibit when it is not necessary. In this example, pacemaker is set to lower relay rate limit of 70 beats per minute. So pacemaker, this is a sense event, that is the P wave, normal intrinsic P wave. It is not pacing. Another intrinsic P wave, it is not pacing, but here there is no intrinsic P wave, so it is pace and followed by a successful P wave. And the pacemaker clock will just run, that is in the 70 beats per minute, that clock is running and observing whether it is intrinsic. If it is intrinsic P wave, it will just observe, it will not inhibit it, not pace. So this is the AAI mode. Next one is the dual chamber modes. Dual chamber modes are divided into two important modes, two important way. That is, one is the tracking mode, another one is the non-tracking mode. Tracking mode means the, what I told earlier, that is the, in the third position, I means inhibit, and T means trigger. So that trigger mode is another way to explain, that is the tracking. So in with this T mode, that is the tracking, triggering mode, we will divide the dual chamber pacemaker in two ways. One is the tracking mode, another one is the non-tracking mode. The tracking mode is the DDD and VDD. And the non-tracking modes are the DDI and DOO. These are the four dual chamber modes. Let us see one by one. That is in the DDD mode, that is the tracking mode, pacemaker pacing in the atrium and ventricle both, that is the D means dual, A and B, pacing in the atrium and ventricle both. Second position, that is the sensing, that is the both, that is the D, both atrium and ventricle sensed, sensing in the atrium and ventricle. And third position is another D, that is inhibit and or trigger. So what is the trigger? That is the intrinsic P wave and QRS complex will inhibit pacing. That is the intrinsic P wave. Intrinsic QRS complex, there is no pacing spike. So intrinsic P wave and QRS complex can inhibit the pacing. And D means trigger. What does it mean? Trigger or tracking? That is the intrinsic P wave or atrial pace. That event can trigger an EVD. So that the normal functioning of the heart, that is the normally the AVD level, AVD is maintained, then the synchrony, if it is maintained, so the proper cardiac output will maintain. So it is very necessary for the proper functioning of the pacemaker as well as a function to give him the total support of the heart. So in this mode, you end up with a pacemaker that can truly adapt to what the heart is doing. The pacemaker will mimic normal conduction as closely as possible. Normally, AV conduction is maintained. Pacemaker will similarly maintain the AV delay, and the total normal function is maintained. So how it will happen? Let us see one by one. In this example, the pacemaker is set to a rate of 60 beats per minute with an AV delay of 200 milliseconds. That is, we will set the pacemaker in 60 beats per minute and we will set AV delay, that is 200 milliseconds. It is programmable. We will set it. And if we will set this program, what pacemaker will do? Let us see. That is, the first one is the sensed P wave. So P wave is sensed when P wave is sensed immediately. Pacemaker clock will start. Pacemaker clock will start. One clock will start accordingly 60 beats per minute. That is 1000 milliseconds. So the 1000 milliseconds it will start the clock. And another clock will start according to the AV delay, that is the 200 milliseconds. So that the AV delay in the 200 milliseconds, if any QRS complex or ventricular complex is there, pacemaker will inhibit. Pacemaker will not do anything, not pace. So within the AV delay, 200 milliseconds, if any intrinsic rhythm occur, pacemaker will just observe and it will see for the next event. So two clock will start. One clock will be at the rate of the 60 beats per minute. That is, again, pacemaker see within 1000 milliseconds any intrinsic activity, actual intrinsic activity occur or not. Here is no intrinsic activity within 1000 milliseconds. So pacemaker will pace. When pacemaker will pace, immediately from the pace event, AV delay, that is the 200 milliseconds, it will count. It will count the 200 milliseconds, the AV delay. In 200 milliseconds, if any intrinsic activity occurs, it will just observe, not paced in the ventricle. Here it is like so. Atrial is paced, immediately it is looking for the AV delay. Within 200 milliseconds, ventricular event, intrinsic ventricular event occurs. So it is ventricle is sensed. There is no ventricular pacing. Again, the clock will start. The atrial in the 1000 milliseconds, after 1000 milliseconds, atrial is paced. And after that, two clock is again start. One is AV delay, one is the atrial pacing. So the AV delay, within the AV delay, 200 milliseconds, there is no intrinsic activity. So that immediately ventricular is paced. So the atrial pace, ventricle pace. So the atrial pace and ventricle pace. Again, the clock is started, and within the 1000 milliseconds, there is no event. So again, the atrial pace and the AV delay start counting. Within the 200 milliseconds, there is no pacing, so atrial pace, ventricle also pace. Again, started, there is atrial is sensed, but there is after sensing the atrial. AV delay is counting within 200 milliseconds. There is no ventricular event, so the pace. So it is the atrial cells and atrial ventricle pace. So these are the ongoing process. If it will continue, one setting it can be happened that the atrial is sensed and ventricle is sensed. Both are sensed. So the last lecture, I told you that the DDD mode, the pacemaker can do the anything like a normal heart. So it can do? It can do the atrial sense and ventricle sense. It can do the atrial sense and ventricle pace. It is the P wave tracking. And another one, the atrial pace and ventricle sense. And also atrial pace and ventricle pace. These are the examples. That is, the patient has the complete inhibition. There is no function of the pacemaker. That is, the patient has a good sinus node function and good AV node function, so there is no need of any pacing. But these are the indication of the paroxysmal sinus node disease or paroxysmal AV block, or the this type of problem we can, this type of event can occur. And another one is the second one, the A sense and B pace. Atrial contraction is sensed, but the ventricle is paced. It is the P wave tracking mode, and patient has a good sinus rhythm, sinus node, but poor AV conduction. So it is atrial sense and ventricle pace. In this setting, atrial pace and ventricle sense. So the sinus node function is poor, but AV conduction is good. So the atrial pace, ventricle sense. in this condition, both these systems are pure, that is the sinus node is pure function and also AV node is function, both the chamber is spaced. So these are the modes of the dual chamber pacemaker, in DDD mode. Another mode is the VDD, which is also a tracking mode, that is the P wave tracking, that is the T function of the T or triggering. In VDD mode, this is a single lead is implanted with the dual function. That is the, in the ventricle, it is paced only in the first position, that is the V, that is the pacing only ventricle. And second position is the D, that is the sense both the atrium and ventricle. And third position is also D, that is it inhibit or trigger. Both it can do this this type of mode. So how it is? Intrinsic QRS, if it is intrinsic QRS, inhibit the ventricular pacing. No ventricular pacing will occur if intrinsic QRS occurs. And the intrinsic PUA only trigger an AVD. That is the intrinsic, if it is in no intrinsic PUA, then our pacemaker will not pace. But if intrinsic QRS is not present, ventricle can pace. But ventricle cannot pace in the atria if intrinsic QA is not there. So if the sinus node is intact, but the AV node is diseased, in that case we can put this type of mode, that is the ventricular pacing, and both the system chamber can be sensed. So that how it is occurred, that is the this example, the pacemaker is set in the rate of 1000 milliseconds and AV delay in the 200 milliseconds. So here you look that the atria is sensed, and then the AV delay 200 milliseconds, both are sensed, and here atria is sensed, another clock is started from the ventricle with the every 1000 milliseconds. Here the ventricle is sensed, but here the P wave, the atria is sensed, but the AV delay is fixed, 200 milliseconds. So after sensing the atria, it will search for the ventricular complex within 200 milliseconds. As it is not present after within the 200 milliseconds, it will face the ventricle. So it will occur. It will occur continuously. And next, in the every 1000 milliseconds, it will just observe. If it is not sensed, it will pace. But as the atria is sensing, and it will maintain AV delay so that ventricle is spaced. Problem is there, that is the every P wave is sensed, every P wave is sensed, but if there is no P wave, there will be the problem in this mode. If there is no P wave, pacemaker will not detect it, not sense it, not pace it. And at that situation, AV delay will not maintain and patient will feel some problem like pacemaker syndrome. So these are the drawbacks of this mode. So able to pace and inhibit the ventricle, sense in the atrium, and ventricle atrium sense will trigger an AV delay, maintain AV synchrony. But usually DDD mode is used in the patients with good sinus node function. Next are the non-tracking mode. Time is over. No. Okay, am I audible? Clearly, Shona Rache. Hello.
Yes, sir. Shona Rache. Yes, sir.
Shona Rache, any problem? Shona Rache.
No, sir. I don't Shona Rache, sir.
Shona Rache. Okay. So the non-tracking mode is the DDI. DDI means, what does it mean? That is the both the chamber phase. And second V means the both the chamber is sensed, that is the atrium ventricle. And I means that it is similar from the what I have told earlier, the response to the sensing, it will either pace or inhibit. So the DDI mode is a bit tricky, but it can be understandable if I will tell you the few slides. It will be both the combination of the AAI and DDI mode. AAI and DDI mode, but it is functioning independently. So it's a bit different from the other modes. It's a bit difficult also. So let us concentrate. That is how it works. In this example, this is the phase bit in this atrium, and in the atrium, here from the both chamber, three clock will start. Here the three clock will start. What the clocks? That is the atrial clock. Every 70 bits per minute it will phase. It is programmed, and from the ventricle also we program that ventricular clock will start and it will phase every 70 bits per minute, or it will observe within 70 bits per minute any intrinsic complex present or not. And there is also a ABDA which we will program, that is around 200 milliseconds. So how it will work, that is the in first example, that is the first one is the phase event, in case in the atrium, after facing the atrium, two clock will start. That is the one atrial clock and one the ABDA clock. ABDA clock, it will see for 200 milliseconds. If it is no intrinsic bit, it will phase. If it is found in its bit, it will just observe. So when it phases, the ventricular event clock will again start. So that the so from the atrium, after 70 bits per minute, it will just observe again. It is also a phased event. There is no intrinsic event. So it is phased event. After that, it will observe ABDA, and it will again phase as there is no intrinsic event. In the next slide, the clock will again start from the atrial event, from the atrial event at the interval, and the DB interval. So that here, after the fixed interval, that is after the 1000 milliseconds, if it is intrinsic beat will occur, then the intrinsic PUI, it is just observed, it will not change. So it is the sensed actual event. And in the sensed actual event, if it is sensed, then as it is the non-tracking mode, after the sensed event, every delay clock will not start. So that every delay clock will not start, and so that the no every delay clock will start. So that how the ventricle is changed, ventricular clock will again start, and ventricle will phase after the fixed 1000 milliseconds, so that the ventricle is phased. In this way, the every interval it will phase or sense, and every ventricular fixed interval it will phase and sense. But there is no PUI tracking. That is, there is no AV delay maintaining. It is, looks like resembles that PUI is tracking, but it is actually not PUI tracking. So that it is there that mode, AV synchrony is not maintained. This is the main drawback of this mode. The sinus atrial rate is slowly increasing until it is fast enough that the patient is able to intrinsically form that down gradient. So that once the PUI is sensed, and another one is also the ventricle is sensed, it can be possible in this mode. But here there is no AV delay maintaining, PUI is not tracking, and the AV delay, if it is AV delay, not maintaining, sometimes the patient can feel some problem, because AV delay is very important for the normal functioning of the human being. So this is the DDI mode. DDI mode is primarily used in patients with atrial tachyarrhythmia. The mode switch algorithm, that is, when it is needed, it will switch to the DDD mode. PUI tracking is great for AV synchrony, but if a patient goes into atrial fibrillation, this mode is usually atrial fibrillation. We use it in atrial fibrillation because we don't want the AV synchrony. If it is the synchrony or AD delay is maintained, that time the electrical fibrillation or axial rate will be 300. And if it is 300, every PoL is tracking and followed by the ventricle will pace at a rate of the 300 beats per minute. So it is not desirable. Patient will develop VF, VT or VF. So this track is the main problem of that scenario. So the PPA tracking is not mandatory in this situation. In DDI non-tracking mode, so that it will be useful in this situation, like atrial fibrillation or atrial flutter. And we want that the dissociation should occur. So we will dissociate the AV symptom in this scenario. So this is the DDI mode. Then next time is very short. I have to conclude in the session. Next one is the fourth chamber, then the rate response. Rate response is, all of you know that the rate response or rate adaptive pacing is due to patient with chronotropic incompetence. Which means that the inability of the heart to appropriately increase its rate with increased activity or metabolic demand produces exercise intolerance, which impairs quality of life. How it occurs? The examples are the exercise, walking down a hallway or climbing stairs. These are the scenario where the chronotropic incompetence is very, very important and rate response therapy is essential. So that this time is used usually in 6 sinus node patients, sinus node dysfunction patients, and how it works. It works like according to some sensors is there in the system, sensors like the accelerometer, because the motion, if motion increase, the pacemaker will catch that motion and accordingly increase its rate. And the minute ventilation is the another sensor that detects the patient's breathing. If breathing is more than the patient, the rate will increase. How it occurs that if the patient is start walking in 75 beats per minute, and gradually increases to 100 beats per minute. So the 75 beats per minute is 100 beats per minute. Automatically, the accelerometer is increased. Also, the minute ventilation sensor is activated, and the rate is increased. So the choosing a pacing mode, how we will choose, it's a very important issue that how we will choose the pacing mode of a patient. So the two important things are there, that is the one is the cardiac output, another one is the AV synchrony. Both are the very important for that issue and interrelated both the terms, that is the cardiac output is the stroke volume and heart rate, all of you know, and the AV synchrony is the timing between the axial and ventricle. So the both are being very interrelated because the atrium and ventricle synchrony is maintaining the stroke volume. Because if it is maintaining the synchrony, the atrial kick, that is the last phase of the cardiac cycle, it will maintain at least 10-30% of the cardiac output. So the stroke volume is absolutely depends on the AV synchrony and start the cardiac output. So that the cardiac synchrony is the main issue to maintain the proper cardiac output, stroke volume, to maintain the normal activity of a person. So the otherwise, if the AV synchrony is not maintained, the main problem will be the pacemaker syndrome. That is, all of you know that some symptoms will occur. Main symptoms are that the normal function only will not maintain by the patient. It is due to the suboptimal AV synchrony or AV dissynchrony or regardless of the pacing mode after a pacemaker implantation. So some symptoms are there, chest pain, cannon hemorrhage, obviously heart failure. These are very important for the exam. All of you are should be asked by the teachers, that is the what are the symptoms, the pacemaker syndrome, what the signs, what are the symptoms. All of you have to know. And the patient will present also to you with this type of symptom, that is a syncope or palpitation or gradually heart failure, some DG spell or syncope may occur, shortness of breath also present. Patient will say you that something is pulsation in my neck, and we also find basal palpitation may be present by the pulmonary edema. So these are the presentation of the pacemaker syndrome, so that the AV symphony is very important. So do you want to maintain AV symphony? Almost always, yes. In order to maintain AV symphony, what we have to require, that is, we have, must have a viable atrium, so that the capable of generating a signal, if you take the atrium, if the atrium is a viable and strong enough, it is sensed by the pacemaker. If you take the atrium, it will mechanically from the pacing pulse and it will maintain the ABD. And the patient must not be chronically in atrial arrhythmia or subatrial flutter or fibrillation. It is not expected. And if the patient has a healthy enough atrium, we will always want to maintain AV symphony if possible. That it would be our aim, that the AV symphony will maintain. So that the, this is my last slide for today. The how we will choose our modes, then the, if the patient is a pacemaker, then we will go for the sinus node function. If it is atrial arrhythmia or it is normal or sinus ready, if it is atrial arrhythmia, then we will go for the, if it is chronic or permanent or persistent atrial arrhythmia, that is the atrial flutter or fibrillation. If it is chronic or permanent, if the patient, then we go for, look for the comorbidity, patient incompetent. If it is yes, then in permanent or chronic fibrillation, we need to go for the DVIR mode. If it is probably not important, incompetent, then can the DVI may be the option. But the patient with paroxysmal atrial fibrillation, atrial arrhythmia, then we again go for the chronic incompetent. We look for that. If it is yes, we will go for the DVDR mode. And if it is no, then we need to the DVD mode. Then next time we will go, if the function is, sinus node function is normal or the sinus ready, then we will look for the AV node conduction is intact or not. What's the position of the AV node? If the AV node is intact, then we will go for the chronically incompetent patient or not. If it is competent, incompetent, so we will go for the AIR mode. And if it is chronically no incompetence, so we can give it AAI mode. But practically and eventually, AAIR and AAI modes are actually obsolete. In the world, very rarely implanted, is not in our country, it also not in USA, another developed country. Nowadays, we are not choosing this mode. And if it is the regular conduction is not intact, then we will go for the patient's rate, that is incompetence and comorbidity, what is the condition. And then we will go for the DDDR mode or DDD mode. So these are all about the course and most of the pacemaker basics. So thank you very much for your patience hearing. Possibly this time is over. I will conclude here. If any question is, if you have any question, you can ask, and I will try to give you the answer.
স্যার আমার একটা প্রশ্ন ছিল স্যার
স্যার
আমি শিবলি রহমান বলছি স্যার ফেজ এ স্যার জি স্যার স্যার যখন স্যার পেসমেকার স্যার অ্যাট্রিয়াকে পেস করছে স্যার তখন স্যার পি ওয়েভটা ইনভার্টেড আসছে স্যার মানে পি ওয়েভ স্যার ইনভার্টেড স্যার পেসমেকার যখন স্যার অ্যাট্রিয়াকে পেস করছে স্যার তখন স্যার পি ওয়েভটা ইনভার্টেড আসতেছে এবং ভেন্ট্রিকলটা স্যার হোয়াইট কিউআরএস আসতেছে স্যার এটা কেন স্যার মানে পি ওয়েভ ইনভার্সন এবং হোয়াইট কিউআরএস কেন স্যার
আচ্ছা এই কেন এটা তো আপনি ফেজে স্টুডেন্ট লেখার কি কোশ্চেনটা করলেন অসুবিধা নাই এটা তো আপনারা ইসিজি ক্লাসে আমি মনে করি আপনারা এগুলো আরো ভালো জানতে পারবেন তারপর আমি বলি যে যখন সাইনাস নোড থেকে একটা পি ওয়েভ অরিজিন হয় হ্যাঁ পি ওয়েভ অরিজিন থেকে ফ্রম দি সাইনাস নোড ইজ ইট আমরা যখন এছাড়া যদি অন্য কোন জায়গা থেকে মানে So anything from the other than the SNO, the complex will be in negative form. In ventricle, it is also, it is a normal conduction, it is the LV, RV, both both the conduction is conduction system. If you think so, that is the how it will occur. That is the we are placing in the only in the RB. So the complex is, TRS complex is a bit wider because the left bundle is already blocked. You are just placing the right ventricle. So left bundle is there, not taking the impulse. So it is the pattern is the left bundle branching morphology. So it is always TRS will be wide. And if it is placing in the atrium other than the SA node, it will always be inverted. So that will be the answer.
Okay, and thank you, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Understand, discover, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Understandable, yes, sir. I'm going to go to the coaching. Make it Bojaga, sir.
মনে হয় নাই স্যার, কোশ্চেন থাকলে করতো স্যার।
ওকে
তাহলে স্যার শেষ করি স্যার।
হ্যাঁ ওকে, থ্যাংক ইউ অল।
ওকে থ্যাংক ইউ স্যার।